Hello all. Today, very important discussion we're going to have about the master plan 2041 for New Delhi. And today we're going to talk about, you know, the landscape part, but most importantly, the water supply, water safety, and the water governance part in New Delhi, because water is something going to be the cause of the Third World War. And to have a successful city, to have a thriving city, and to have a city which goes on forever, we need to manage our water wisely. And to talk about this, we have Ms. Savitri Kumari. Ms. Savitri Kumari, most welcome.
Thank you.
So I'll introduce Savitri, ma'am, for all of you. You know, Savitri ji did her Bachelor of Planning from SPA Vijayawada. That's a School of Planning and Architecture, Vijayawada. Then she came to do her Urban Planning Masters from School of Planning and Architecture, New Delhi, where she started as a research associate, and she's currently a research scholar under fellowship in the Department of Physical Planning at the School of Planning and Architecture, New Delhi. And she's currently working on water, and that too, water in Delhi. And, you know, with all the areas of governance, supply, and all the management. So great to have you here, ma'am.
Thank you, sir, for giving me the opportunity.
So, you know, thank you so much for joining. And, you know, I would request you if I could just start with the questions, you know. So the Delhi Master Plan 2041 proposes a blue-green policy. And blue definitely means water. So do you think there is a deserving mention of water in the Delhi Master Plan 2041?
Okay. So before answering this question, first of all, I will tell you about the how water is being the sources of water in Delhi, what are the various sources, and then how it is being supplied through the various treatment plant to the secondary reservoirs and then primary reservoirs and then finally to the household level. So in case of Delhi, we all know that Delhi has 90% of water supply is being through river Yamuna, and since the estimated from the master plan 2021, it was estimated that the population is around 20 million. But in the 2041 master plan, we can see that the population is around 29.9 million. And the present demand is for the water is around 1135 MGD, whereas in the 2041 master plan, it is 1455. But the current.
So, quick question, ma'am, what is MGD? So,
it's million gallon per daily.
Oh, that's million a lot gallon. Of water, a lot of yes. water. So that is the unit of measurement for city level, right?
Yes. So if we see from the previous in 1962 master plan, that time we used to calculate in million gallon in liters. It was right. Liter, but now we are using the gallon. So in 1 gallon, we have around 4.5 liters.
Oh.
So it's a very big number. So it's a huge number. So we are just calculating it in gallons. So right. I was telling about those various sources.
Sources, so, yes.
So in Delhi is largely dependent on the river Yamuna. It is around 40% water. And apart from that, we have Ganga River, then Vakra storage. So, and only 10% is the groundwater that Delhi itself has. So in the year 1994, there was an agreement with the four neighboring states, that was Himachal Pradesh, Uttar Pradesh, Haryana, and Rajasthan. And with that agreement, Delhi people are getting water. So many other scholars have also studied that in Delhi, around 20% of the people are getting 92% of water, while remaining 80% are getting only 8% water.
Wow, so that's a lot of inequity,
Yes, so we can see that there is a lot of inequities there. So from this master plan, how we can distribute equally water, because we have in Delhi is a state as well as a union territory where land is being governed by the Delhi Development Authority, and the water is being supplied by Delhi Jal Board, which is an institution which is being formed under the Delhi Jal Board Act of 1998. So why there was this need for the separate water body was there? That was felt because of a different story. But I'll tell the very interesting fact that in that Delhi Jal Board Act, it is clearly mentioned that water will be supplied only to the planned colonies. It won't supply to the unplanned illegal colonies, unauthorized colonies. In there, it was mentioned in the section 9A of the Act. So there we can see that there is a nature of exclusionary nature, that we call it as an exclusionary nature. So
right.
in the current Master Plan 2041, how the government has included those colonies, those unauthorized colonies, and then try to make justice is very interesting to see. So coming back to your question that how blue is there. So in the case, as I had already mentioned, that 90% of water supply for Delhi is being from the outside state. So it's very interesting that how we manage the river Yamuna. Though we have very we have action plans, river Yamuna action plans. So for that we have made very great initiatives to rejuvenate the water bodies also, and the ponds and lakes, and also try to
so I my next question is exactly this. As Delhi depends on river Yamuna, which is shared by many states, there is a multiple events of interstate crisis. Sometimes they say we don't have water, so we cannot give you water. So is it time for Delhi to aim at self-sustainability, as you're talking about the multiple reservoirs and the lakes, and you know, by creating more internal sources like lakes and reservoirs? Do you think it's possible, and do you think it should be done, ma'am?
Yes, clearly in the 2041 master plan, we can see that they are talking about demand side management. Right now, they are talking of demand side management. Earlier, they used to talk about the supply side management. In the supply side management, they have tried to augment new water sources, such as they have tried to build new three dams. They are Renuka, then Laskar Vyas, and then Keshavpur. These were the three dams they have proposed. From that dam, it is estimated that around 785 MGD water will come. But
right.
since the population is also increasing, right now we have the population of 20 million, but in 2041, it is estimated that it will be around 29.1 million population will be there. So for fulfilling the demand is will that water will be sufficient or not. So from that point of view, they are now trying to think in a different approach, that is integrated water management approaches they have highlighted, and simultaneously they are talking about the demand side management. In
right.
demand side management, what they are trying to do is they are talking about the City of Lake projects, where
yes.
In that we have seen, and one of the example is Rajokri project. It is one of the project that has been awarded by the Ministry of Jal Shakti, and also taking this as a best practice example, they are trying to rejuvenate the other water bodies also. In case of Delhi, we have around 1100 closely 1100 water bodies, in which
right.
there are some 900 traceable water bodies, and there are some around 300 non-traceable bodies. So they are trying to trace those water bodies by including the other agencies also. So
right.
in this time, in the master plan, we can see that other agencies have highlighted their points, and then they have written to the concerned DDA to include those. So in the DJB also has requested for the conservation of water bodies, and also trying to reuse the water. Like
yes.
In case of right now, we have 935 MGD of water that is being supplied. And if you calculate, around 80% is being wastewater. So it
yes.
is coming. So roughly around 500 water is being treated. And that treated
yes.
water, what we are doing is right now, we are just throwing it back to the water in River Yamuna. So it's
yes.
very important that we try to take as our to fulfill our demand. Like we have a gap of around 200 in master plan, it is 141 MGD. So that MGD try to fulfill from
yes.
that side. So that is one thing. Then apart from that, we have another projects also, like Palla project. In that, what they are trying to do is, they are trying to take the water to Palla, and from there they will be
so where is this Palla, ma'am?
Palla,
yeah,
Palla is near Gurgaon.
Gurgaon, okay, south,
yes,
south Delhi.
Yes. So from there, they are trying to in case of Delhi, we can see only the 22 kilometer stretch of river Yamuna, but they are actually 50 kilometer stretch. In 22 kilometer stretch is the polluted stretch that we see, and 28 kilometer is the fresh water that. So it's very interesting to actually understand the whole mechanism of how the water is being procured and then treated, and then it is being supplied. So before water entering to Delhi, the most of the water is being taken to Wazirabad barrage there, and then from there it is being taken to the various treatment plants like Wazirabad, Chandawal, Bhagirathi, and so on like that. We have different water treatment plants. So from right. there, it is being, so now what I was telling about was the Palla project. So in
yes.
Palla project, basically what they are trying to do is that they were trying to take the sewerage wastewater from Delhi, and then trying to mix with the water in the river Yamuna, so that it becomes diluted, and then they can again treat it, and then they can increase the water how much they are taking to back to Delhi. So
yes.
this is another type of project they are trying to do it now. So these are few of the projects that I have mentioned. Apart from that, there are other projects also, like hydrological project is there that they have mentioned in the master plan. So
okay.
that is there. So
okay. Absolutely. So draft MPD 2041 aims to reduce demand of potable water for domestic use rationally and progressively to 50 gallons per capita daily from the present 60 GPCD. So this is apart from what you said. You know, there's also a plan to reduce this daily demand from 50 gallons to 250 gallons from the current 60 GPCD. Is this another way of data manipulation to create a better picture, or some rationalization can be a good idea for Delhi?
Actually, the thing is, like, here what they are trying to do is that right now we have the treated wastewater there is a plant, Keshwapur plant,
yes.
where the water is being treated, and that is absolutely you can drink it, but due to people's behavior or maybe due to some infrastructure lacking, we are not using it up to its maximum capacity. What we
right.
are doing is we are just throwing it back to river Yamuna.
Yes.
So now this MPD highlights that we should use the treated wastewater. So for that, they are trying to do take is as a dual pipe system and some
yes.
infrastructural
yes.
measures they are telling it. But the thing is, like, what they are right now, we have 225 LPCD, like they have calculated as the demand for a mega city like Delhi. 225 LPCD is the requirement they have calculated. In that, they are trying to say that we have two type of uses. One is potable type we are having domestic uses. In that, we have drinking, flushing, and other activities. And then we have another sort of activities for car washing, then gardening, and others. So for gardening, car washing, we can use the treated water.
Yes.
So in that sense, they are telling that non-potable water can be used. So that is the interpretation which I can make out from the rationalization.
So ma'am, do you think this is a viable, in Delhi, first to have, the single system to reach everywhere is a big challenge. Do you think it will
yes.
be possible to have a double plumbing system to reach the whole Delhi, where you're talking about a, alternate system for, the treated water to be used for car washing and other things? Do you think it's a viable option for Delhi?
Definitely, it's not viable in all the areas, because we have very narrow lanes. Like, we all know that Delhi is being called the Galika. So there are a lot of gullies. So in that, we cannot have these sort of dual piping system because of the infrastructure, because of the engineering issues, whatever the reasons may be. So there are many reasons. So we cannot do for all the areas, but in few areas, like where in the plant colonies, like in case of Dwarka, Narela, Rohini, where the DDA is developing new townships, in that areas, these dual piping system, they had made mandatory in this master plan. Right. Earlier, we don't have this dual system mandatory in the previous plans. So that's the thing this master plan is tries to cover it up.
So you said, thank you, ma'am, for the answer. You said that Delhi is the gully ka, and you know, you spoke about how it's such a congested city. And you know, apart from the current congested places that we had, the government is also fast recognizing more unauthorized colonies in Delhi. These colonies at the end contain humans who need water for everyday uses. You know, there is a lack of water supply already to many such areas, and they depend on the tanker mafia. Do you think the MPD 2041 addresses this area of, you know, supply of water to these unauthorized colonies?
Actually, in the current situation, what we have seen that in unauthorized colonies, people are not only dependent on the tanker system, there is a huge number of colonies which are dependent on the bore wells, underground, groundwater.
Yes.
So, if the government is providing piped water supply in these areas, then the dependency on the groundwater, it will be it will reduce. This tanker system, like in case of Delhi, Delhi Jal Board has its own around 800 tankers are there. Mainly these tankers are used for two, three type of purposes. First is for if you have some functions or some use is there in your home, then you can call for the tanker. And then in the during the summer seasons, when the demand is not fulfilled that time, and then of course in the for the providing water to the slums areas and in unauthorized colonies, it's there. But in unauthorized colony, people are not only dependent on these tankers, but they are largely dependent on groundwater. Borewells, yes, their own. And in those areas also, we can see that the groundwater table is decreasing.
Absolutely.
From the reports that the CPCB has published and other agencies are just studying. So,
ma'am, you just told about the depleting groundwater due to these bore wells. So, ma'am, has there been enough focus on the creation of rainwater harvesting to, you know, help this depleting groundwater, you know, for Delhi in the master plan 2041?
Yes, this rainwater harvesting is being given in the previous master plan also, and in the 2041 master plan also. And this time, this has been made mandatory for all the ULBs. Like in Delhi, we have five ULBs, urban local bodies. North Delhi Municipal Corporation, South Delhi Municipal Corporation, East Delhi Municipal Corporation, then New Delhi Municipal Council, and Delhi Cantonment Board. So there are total five. So now this time they have made mandatory for all the all these local bodies to, when they are sanctioning the plants, they have to ensure that this rainwater harvesting is being done, and then they issue the certificate. And apart from that, TJB has also taken the initiatives where they are giving the 10% rebate in the their water supply connection, in the water supply bills. And all those other initiatives are being providing incentives to the people.
Absolutely.
And then there are other challenges also. Like in Delhi, there are different areas where the groundwater table is already at a it's good. It's not everywhere. It's water table is low in somewhere. Like for example, in case of ITU, where groundwater table is just it's normal. So in that area, rainwater harvesting is not done in all the institutional you have seen that in all the buildings it's not done. It's because of various reason, and I can just tell that it's not rain harvesting is not only just you have to recharge the groundwater. It's also that how you can conserve the water for your future use. Like in other states, like in case of Gujarat, I have seen that there the people conserve water in the form of tanks they build while making their house. They just make an underground tank and then they just conserve the rainwater and then they use throughout the year. Similar manner, it can be done in Delhi also, where rainwater harvesting is not done properly for it's not possible.
Not possible.
To recharge.
What you just said is wherever recharge is not possible, direct mm-hmm. collection of water should be made possible so that this water can be used in the dry parts of the year and, you know, whenever water is needed. So thank you so much, ma'am, for, you know, informing us about that. Ma'am, next question is about, you know, this ambitious policy of the Delhi government of providing 24 hours of potable water in the taps of Delhi. When we mentioned about so much inequity and we mentioned about so much, you know, shortage of water, do you think this is possible? Do you think it's too ambitious for the Delhi government to declare this, or do you think this is actually possible?
This is possible in few areas, but it is not possible in all the areas. The reason being that in Delhi we have around 50 to 60 year old infrastructure, like pipelines are so old, and it is very difficult also sometimes to map exactly in which area what type of pipeline is there. Right. So there are very ill, and there are there are too many illegal tappings are also there that leads to the unaccounted of water supply.
Right.
So if the the whole Delhi people are not getting connected with the proper network, formal network supply, then it won't be possible to give the 24 water supply. Like in a few year back, there was a project in South Delhi in Malviya Nagar, and that was a Gitanjali enclave where they had tried to do the 24 water supply. Yeah. But somehow it's in few areas it is working, but it's not completely working in throughout the area, because in Delhi we are not only having the planned colonies, we are having unplanned organic type of development is also there.
Yes.
So personally I am speaking on this topic, so I don't think that it is possible to supply 24 hour water supply in all the areas, but yeah, exceptionally in few areas it is definitely possible. Based on some permutation combinations, they can do it.
Right. Thank you for that answer, ma'am. So, you know, as far as water is concerned, what do you think that this master plan 2041 has absolutely missed?
Most of the things it has covered, but yes, definitely one of the things that needs to be look after it, that how this treated water is being reused, like how we are going to reuse in our homes, because there are very people's perceptions are different for using it. Some people think that ye ganda pani fir se hum kaise use kar sakte hain, and there are a lot of other like cultural values and social values. There are so many values associated with this water when we think about the treated water using again in our homes. So
yes,
that is the thing. So I think in this master plan, I hope that people will come out with better ways how that this people's thinking will get changed. But yes, definitely in master plan, it's a vision document. It says vision document how the city has to be governed in that sense. It cannot tell the people's perception, but some technical aspect has to definitely come with from this master plan.
Absolutely. Mm-hmm. Ma'am, you have covered so much today. You know, you told us about this whole blue coloration of the Delhi master plan and how water is such an important thing in Delhi, and how water needs to be focused, and how the government is doing in the master plan. They thought about, you know, this parallel piping system. You told about the inequity in water supply to unauthorized colonies, and you know how bore wells are being used there. You also spoke and you gave an answer about whether a 24 hours potable water would be possible. You also spoke about, you know, rationalization of water and all the other important topics related to water in the Delhi master plan. Now, ma'am, I want to ask you, if there is one thing that you want that should definitely be part of the master plan because it's open to public consultation, what would that thing be?
See, the master plan is not only about a document that is being made by an agency. It's something that is related to the people,
Yes.
how they want their city to be, and what all they are, their expectation is. The master plan is something that is, because
Yes.
we all know that master plan is a statutory document. So with this master plan, what this is the my views is, like, people should try to understand that water is not a community resource. It's their individual also. They have
Okay.
to think about it's as an individual and try to save it, because
Yes.
we have seen that the water has become a scarce resource, as because we are now earlier we were making dams to augment our water supply, but now we are not doing that. We are trying
Yes.
to manage it. Demand management approach, we are doing it by conserving various water bodies and other initiatives that we are taking. So
Absolutely.
my opinion about this master plan is that the people, the common people, should understand the importance of water, that they should conserve it at that individual level. Though the government is trying to make initiatives, but at individual level, because one of the example I can say, it's from my personal experience, that while we all fill our water tanks every day, but sometimes we just forget, and then water just come out for
overflows
it
for
hours and hours. And it's not only for one individual household. If we think about as a community, how much water we just waste every day. So how much that wastage is going back to the, until and unless we as individual understand the importance of water, definitely if many initiatives can be taken, but that will not work proper on ground. So as an individual, we should just think in that manner, that it's our responsibility to just conserve the water by taking these small initiatives. These are just small initiatives. In this way, we can just save our electricity also, and at the same time, we can save the water also. So simultaneously, we can just do two works. So that's the one message that I want to give to our viewers, that this is very important. And yes, in a master plan, definitely we should be doing that, like parks and other green spaces should be using the treated water. Right now they are also using it, but still they need to be more and more taking water in it. So, and also the industry should take the treated wastewater for their purposes, for their fulfilling their demand. So,
absolutely,
yes.
absolutely. You know, with so much important information on Delhi's water scenario, and you know, also giving us such an important message that, you know, when all the, you know, multi-crore people of Delhi, when everybody takes small effort and not thinking water is something that the community manages, but rather it is something that we as individuals manage, we will have a situation where water will be conserved in totality, and we will have, you know, less effort at a larger scale to, you know, get more water, because conservation is creation at the end.
Yes.
So
yes.
thank you.
Yes, and please. This is how we are this is how the government is trying to link this green and blue infrastructure in the master plan. Like, their vision is for the green and blue infrastructure. So
absolutely. Thank you so much for, you know, sharing important information on water today, and I'm sure all the viewers really, really enjoyed watching this, because there's so many new things that you told us about, that how, you know, that Yamuna River is not the one that we see. It is diverted from the point that it enters Delhi, and it's diverted to all the Wazirabad, and it's diverted to all you know, treatment plants, which is something that most Delhiites will not know about. The thing that only that, you know, that dark colored water body that is polluted is Yamuna, but actually Yamuna is much more than that, and it is supplying water to us every single day. So thank you so much, ma'am.
Thank you.